So once again, we have another instance of the NBA offseason being the most entertaining part of the NBA since the Warriors choked a 3-1? Maybe? I don't know. I mean, I feel like everything is going down at this point. We're seeing just so many blockbuster moves. We had Jimmy Butler, we had Chris Paul, and now, of course, the one that maybe has been more anticipated than any other, just because of the fact that Paul George came out and said he wasn't coming back to the Pacers in 2018. He wanted to be on the Lakers, and Paul George was sent last night, of course, as we all know, but for those who don't know, to the Oklahoma City Thunder in exchange for Victor Oladipo and Domantas Sabonis. I believe that's how you say that, right? And look, everybody already knows this happened, so there's a little bit of a different dynamic to this video. Instead of just talking about the trade, I'm going to talk about what the future of the Oklahoma City Thunder means with this trade. I'm going to talk about the future of the Pacers means with this trade. Basically, just going to detail who won and who lost, of course. And there are reasons why. I mean, look, it's very hard to say because at first glance, it looks like the Pacers got absolutely swindled in this trade. And people are going crazy for Oklahoma City. They're saying OKC totally won this trade. But there's so many things you have to pay attention to with this. Because, first of all, the Pacers had to trade Paul George one way or another. And the deal that we're going to get for Paul George might not have been as great as you might think, just because of the fact that he was gone anyway. Teams know that the Pacers have to trade Paul George, so they offer the Pacers less in exchange for PG-13. That way, you know, it's like the Pacers can't deny a bad deal in the end, because if they don't trade him before 2018 free agency, he's gone for good and they have nothing to show for. This way, they pick up Oladipo, a nice young player, and Domantas Sabonis, who, coming into his second year, he could be something, he might not be something, but two young guys for the Oklahoma City Thunder, but nothing certain. I mean, the ceiling for both these guys isn't that high, I don't think. Oladipo's been in the league a few years, and I think we pretty much know what we're going to get from him. I really doubt Indiana can turn him into a star player. Sabonis, it's not as clear, but he's another guy that, do you really think he's going to be a star player? And that's all they got. I don't think they even got a pick out of this. And these are the only two players they got. So, yeah, it might not seem like a lot, but in a way, they kind of had to. Also, people aren't keeping in mind the fact that Paul George is a rental player. If he doesn't sign an extension, which, I mean, do you really think he's going to after what he's talking about the Lakers? What makes you think that Paul George isn't just going to dip out and join the LA Lakers in 2018 offseason? I mean, the Oklahoma City Thunder aren't stacked. They're not going to be a top four seed, I don't think. People are acting like this is huge news and this team is going to go over the top. And yeah, this team might be better than they were last year. But I don't think they're going anywhere in the playoffs. If they will make it, but I'm not a believer right now in this team. And if this team doesn't get at least two rounds in, why would Paul George stay with this team? He wants to play in LA. If he's not contending for anything, what's the point of him being somewhere else? I guess you never know how things are gonna go. Maybe he's gonna love OKC, but it seems like he's got his mind set on the LA Lakers, and once this season's over, he's probably gone. So if that happens, if they get 5 or 6 seed and they make the playoffs and they lose in the first round and Paul George leaves, what does OKC have to show for this? Absolutely nothing, because they lost Sabonis and Oladipo for Paul George, who's gone now too. So for me, it's like, if you're OKC, you gotta sign somebody else. You gotta get another player to pair with these two guys. And I know that a lot of people might be thinking, okay, look, this is gonna be one of the best dynamic duos in the league next season. And it might be. But I don't know. For whatever reason, it's just hard for me to have a ton of confidence in this team, because I don't really think this team, first of all, has any type of support. Who's their shooting guard going to be? Is it going to be Andre Robertson alongside Westbrook and Paul George? I mean, that's okay, I guess. You lose a lot of offense with that. Who's your power? Like, Taj Gibson's a free agent, and Steven Adams is solid at center, but the depth on this team has got to be concerning. And look, if they make a few good signings, they sign a few good role players, and even, you know, a guy that can be like a specialist, and I said maybe another star if they want to contend, but this team isn't beating the Warriors, this team isn't beating the Spurs or the Rockets, I think. So I'm not convinced. I might be one of the only people like that. People are going crazy over this, and we'll see. But this trade doesn't blow me away for either team, obviously. So, look, people are saying Indiana got fleeced. Yeah, I mean, they didn't get a fair trade, but they kind of had to trade Paul George, and it's fortunate that they got something for it. Now, a new wrinkle comes into this with the fact that we talk about, you know, these Celtics offers. And the Celtics, you know, they're always trying to get everybody, and it's funny because the Celtics are about to miss out on literally everybody, and it's going to be the funniest thing in the world. But the Celtics, I feel like, I don't remember what the specific offer was, but I feel like they offered at least one of their picks, and they offered a player. Maybe Jaylen Brown was in there. I'm not sure, but the Celtics gave them, when I saw the deal, and I'm not sure this is confirmed, but like, this Celtics deal that I saw looked better than the one OKC gave them. But yet, anyway, they went for the OKC way. And look, I don't know how certain, you know, that other trade was, but I just feel like they could have gotten something better. Simply said, they didn't get a whole lot. Maybe the market wasn't great. We don't know. Just because of the fact that, look, these guys, they're just giving out Paul George. Anybody can have him. Because it's like, well, we'll just take the best offer that we get, no matter how bad it is. Why would you keep Paul George and then just lose him? So, you know, I mean, and they could have waited to trade him at the trade deadline this season. But, you know, I think it's better to get started with your new players earlier, just because you're going to lose him anyway. What's the point of keeping hold of him? You guys aren't going to do anything next season anyway. So, yeah, I understand that. Do feel like they could have gotten a better deal. I feel like they were probably offered a better deal. And then let's talk a little bit more about the Oklahoma City Thunder. People are going crazy, like I'm saying. Do you really think Paul George is re-signing with the Oklahoma City Thunder in 2018? Do you really think he's going to? Yeah, these two could be a dynamic duo, Westbrook and Paul George. They could be fantastic. This team could be a 3-seed. I mean, that's really the ceiling, I think, for this team. That would be very surprising by my standards. But even if they were a 3-seed and they lost in the second round, Paul George had a decision to make. And I do think it's good, actually, that they were getting rid of Oladipo. They had to get rid of either Oladipo or Adams. They made the right decision. And the reason why they had to get rid of one of those players is because they completely overpaid them this year. And they need space for someone else. They're trying to contend. If you have Westbrook on your team, you're going to need to find other players to build around him. He's one of those guys he's going to be the number one guy on the championship team, I believe, if you put the right pieces around him. And I think that Paul George is a start. He's not the end game. You have to have more than this, especially with the lack of depth this team has right now. So expect some free agency signings. But also, look, this could go completely backwards for OKC if Paul George decides to leave. So that's why there's a huge question mark. That's why I'm not so sure about this deal. Either way, the East and West are so unbalanced. It's not funny. It's actually scary for the league because in the fact that, like, I'm scared for you know, the state of the NBA because I don't like this at all. The East is going to be so weak next year. We're going to get another LeBron in the finals after losing like one game in the playoffs. And we're going to have this crazy intense battle of like six teams in the West. But the Warriors are going to inevitably come out of the West anyway. And I just can't. I don't know if I can take more of this. Yeah, it's interesting. But does it all really matter? Yeah, maybe in a few years these moves will start coming into effect. And we'll be able to feel the wrath of these new players and these new teams. But look, I don't think it does anything right now for this season. Maybe these teams get better. They're not beating the Warriors. That's gonna do it. If you enjoyed it, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and I'm out. Thanks for watching, y'all. Peace.